This is Bomb Hoops Podcast.
Hi everyone, we're Bomb Hoops Podcast, hosted by Jem and Jello. So make sure to like, comment, share this podcast to your friends, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also follow us on Spotify, Anchor, and Google Podcasts. Just check the description down below for the details. Our episodes are also available on our official Facebook page, so make sure to check it out. And lastly, don't forget to follow our socials at Palm Hoops on Instagram and Twitter. So, ito ang topic natin for today. Actually, we are shooting this at 11:43 in the evening. And supposedly, hindi yan yung topic namin. Pero nagulat kami sa nakita namin sa Twitter.
Mainit na pandesal eh.
Oo.
Bagong luto.
Na si CJ McCollum nga, all things considered, will be headed to the New Orleans Pelicans. So, sobrang mind-blowing na trade na to, and it's an end of an era for CJ McCollum na iiwanan niya na yung team na nag-draft sa kanya.
And so, ano, sobrang under the radar na trade na to. Kasi walang rumblings. Sabi nila, pag rumor trade, hindi natutuloy talaga.
So, ina-expect ko nga si Lillard ang matitrade eh. Kasi since the preseason and the offseason pa lang last time, may mga offers na sa kanya, may mga rumors na naaalis siya, na sumasama na siya kila LeBron, ganun. Mm. Nasa Laker fan, umasa ako. Pero, ayun na nga, and looks like Damian Lillard will be shut down for the rest of the season, and they are committing to have a full rebuild.
And don't be surprised kung si Lillard matrade na rin by the offseason, even if ayaw niya. So, and well, let's go back to the trade. Basically, yung trade, well, at least for the names currently considered right now, it's CJ McCollum for Josh Hart and draft picks. For the draft picks, it's still TBA. Wala pang ina-announce so far as we are talking about this at 11:45 in the evening.
Kaya wag nyo kami i-bash if may
changes dun sa trade. Pero yun yung ano, basics ng trade. It's CJ for Josh Hart and draft picks. So, what's in it for the Pelicans muna? I think this is a pressure move from Zion probably leaving the Pelicans. Kailangan nila mag-build ng win now team, and they saw CJ McCollum sa winning piece. Kumbaga, we have to find someone na kailangan na kaya mag-contribute sa team na to. That is a help to Zion, or else he might leave us. Although CJ personally is not a needle moving player para sa akin. Pressure eh. Kailangan mo talaga maghanap ng player na makakatulong doon sa team, or else you lose your superstar. Parang kanino ba siya ka-compare? Maybe yung moves nung Cavs nung first stint ni LeBron. They got Mo Williams, they got Larius ba yun? Tama si Larius.
Pati si Shaq nga eh. At si Shaq, some point, nakuha nila eh.
Kumbaga, so, kailangan mo kumuha ng player na magko-contribute even if it's not a significant contribution if you want to maintain your superstar.
But I think CJ McCollum is significant naman. I mean, I'm pretty sure if wala siya sa Portland Trailblazers, or kuyari, nasa isang team siya na walang kahati sa scoring, He will be an all-star. So, etong trade na to, I think, baka, ano, panalo dito ang Pelicans. Kasi, though, hindi pa namin sure kung ilang picks yung ipamibigay. I'm, siguro, significant number of picks yan. Kasi, madami namang first rounders ang Pelicans from the Anthony Davis trade. So, siguro one or two first round picks, Josh Hart for CJ McCollum. I think that's a pretty fair comparison naman. I mean, fair exchange for both teams.
And I think may nawa pa silang first round picks dun sa sign and trade ni Lonzo. So, if ever, panalo pa rin sila. And I doubt na isama nila yung first round pick nila for this year. If ever na, alam ko na sa kanila pa rin yung first round pick na yun. So malabong isama nila yun, kasi considering kung nasan sila ngayon sa standings, I think they're at the bottom 2, bottom 3 of the standings in the West ngayon. Pero ayun, all things considered, dun sa lineup, they have to win by next season.
Oo. And I think may option na si Zion Williamson by next season kung aalis ba siya o hindi.
Ang best na kaya niyang gawin, this is a video that I watch in Mike Corzemba. Shout out to Mike Corzemba. Na if ever, since last season niya na as a contract player under the current contract niya by next season, if I'm not mistaken, pwede siyang mag-qualifying offer lang after nun he's an unrestricted free agent.
Which can give him a max contract, if ever.
It's a flight risk considering sa pera. Kasi what if he gets injured again and doesn't get that super max? Pero if Zion really wants to leave, he'll be the first one to do that.
So, actually, sinasabi naman ni Zion Williamson na G siya, maglaro sa Pelicans, sadya nag-recover lang siya, ganun. So, pero ang bali-balita, pamilya niya yung may ayaw sa Pelicans. And nakikita nga sa weight gain ni Zion na masarap talaga
ang pagkain sa New Orleans. Patry naman.
Oo. Penge.
Penge naman na shrimp gumbo.
Di ba yung sponsor ng Pelicans, yung Zatarain's ba yun?
Oo.
Parang condiment yun eh. Pagkain yun eh. So, anyway, let's analyze yung magiging team ng Pelicans in this trade. So, assuming na si Josh Hart lang yung player na makukuha ng Portland from the Pelicans. Ang starter nila will be at point guard, Devontae Graham. Shooting guard, si CJ McCollum. Tapos, small forward nila will be Brandon Ingram. Power forward, Zion Williamson. And center nila, si Jonas Valanciunas. I think that team, kung healthy lahat, can be a top 5 team sa Western Conference.
If starters only. Kasi if you're looking at the bench of the New Orleans Pelicans, I'm sorry, New Orleans, no disrespect, pero nobody's yung bench nila.
Yeah, puro project players. Nickel Alexander-Walker. Though at spurts, nakikita mo may potential, pero hindi pa siya yung reliable na player. And si Jackson Hayes nga, another project player din, pero ang dami niya ring issues outside the court. So, do you think na maaasahan mo moving forward yung ganyang player? So, pero regardless, this is a major improvement for the Pelicans. And at siguro naman by next year, if intact sila, they can make, I'm pretty sure they're a playoff team. Play-in team at worst.
Kasi last year, they were buying for a spot. At least, late in the season, they were still buying for a spot until they fell off.
And yun nga, injury na nga ni Zion Williamson. Pero Zion Williamson was averaging 27 points per game.
At insane percentages. I think he and Shaq are the only two players to average those points and those percentages in a season.
Kaya di ako magugulat kung biglang papayat niyang si Zion this next few weeks. Baka ganahan na maglaro. Wow, lakas ang kakampi ko. Matry nga.
Pero ayun, going back, they're formidable in terms of the starting five. They can compete, pero they need to improve that bench production, which I think they can in the offseason naman, since they have, I think they still have cap space considering that in three, or maybe not, kasi apat na yung players nila that I think are they're paying big money in Valanciunas, Zion, Ingram, and CJ McCollum. Although si Zion is still on a rookie contract, syempre anticipated naman yun.
Pero with that kind of team na bata, you don't necessarily have to get parang
mga
star players ganun. You just need to get veterans na who can show you the way. Someone like yung sabi mo, sila Patty Mills, mga Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, those kinds of players na reliable, not star players, mga Rajon Rondo ganun. Baka bumalik ng Pelicans. I remember yung performances ni Rajon Rondo sa Pelicans noon, yung nagte 22 assists in a game. So, pero mukhang masaya ang buhay ni Rondo sa Cavaliers ngayon.
Wow. Sitting so, pretty eh.
Oh, mukhang mukhang dumadark horse pa sa championship if ever. Pero going back to the topic, they need a veteran presence kasi puro bata eh, and ang nako-consider mo yung veterano doon si Jonas Valanciunas na,
and he's not the type of player na leader sa team.
Oh, actually nakikita mo sa mga emotional tantrums niya sa court na he needs someone to keep him in check. And pero if you look at the starting five na ganun, para lahat yan kayang maging 20 points per game scorer. Oh, siguro hindi si Devonte Graham lang yung
pinakamababa yung ano, average.
Siguro mga 15 points per game at worst. Yan. So, which is not bad for a point guard. And with that, mababawasan yung defensive ano focus kay
Ingram.
Kay Ingram. Zion. Yes. Kasi, especially ngayon kay Ingram na wala pa si Zion. Kasi, hindi na lang siya yung ano, lone scorer, lone shot creator. May kahati na siya. So, teams won't be, I mean, will be risking some if they will commit on double teaming si CJ or si Ingram.
Well, ang maganda actually with at least the current core of Zion, Ingram, and McCollum, they score at different positions in the court, at different spots on the court. CJ is an inside, actually an outside in scorer. Ingram's more of a mid-range inside scorer. Then Zion's is a paint scorer. So, walang sapaw. And they all present skill sets na different that are essential for their positions. Kumbaga, they are the prototypical players for their position.
And if they're young and kung magiging intact yung core na yan, they will be a force to be reckoned with siguro 2 to 3 years from now. They need another defensive ano minded player kasi pansinin mo sa lineup nila,
walang offensive minded eh.
Walang anchor eh. So and nakita nga natin sa nangyari sa Brooklyn Nets this past season and Houston Rockets for the most of the 2010 decade. It's not enough that you outscore the opponent. Hindi ubro sa playoffs yan. So, kailangan ninyo ng, ano, ng defensive anchor, which is si Herbert Jones.
Developing.
Mukhang, and sinasabi nga nila na he might be the best defensive player this draft class. So, kung ma-develop nila yun into a solid, a strong wing defender, hindi naman siguro Kawhi Leonard levels pero someone like Marcus Smart, mga ganun.
Pwede na. Yan,
magandang addition yan moving forward. So, punta naman tayo sa Portland Trailblazers na, ayun nga, speaking of Damian Lillard, mukhang hindi na siya maglalaro this season. And I think he will opt for surgery na ata if ever ganyan yung mangyayari.
Oh, ano, I'm calling it Lillard to the Lakers 2023. Kasi,
okay,
to be honest, I mean, it's not far from possibility.
May rumors kasi naman talaga.
It's long been rumored. Same time, rebuilding na talaga as in binibreak up na nila yung team ng Portland. I think Lillard won't stay for a third rebuild dito sa Portland. Even if he wants to, Portland would rather trade him. Kasi, kung ako yung team, although I know making money is the best thing for me, if I want to make it big, hindi na pwede ito eh. Kasi this will just lead to mediocre attendance, mediocre standings. I won't gain that much if I am winning, if I am losing this. Mas okay kung nananalo talaga ako. Eh kung mediocre team lang kami, wag na lang, di ba? I think most of the teams are like that naman.
So, eh si Lillard nga din, parang ang pinakamalayo niya nang narating sa playoffs was the
Conference Finals
na winalis pa sila ng
way back 2019 ba?
2019
yung last niya, 2019.
So ayun, medyo parang for after almost naka 10 years na siya, no? So, 10th year niya na ngayon. 2012 siya, 'di ba?
Hindi, ano pa lang niya ngayon? It's actually his 9th year in the league.
Oh, 9th year.
Oh, wait, sorry. Oh, tama. 10th year nga niya sa league.
So, kumbaga 10 years ka nang hindi nagcha-champion. And for a superstar like Damian Lillard, mahirap tanggapin yan. no matter how loyal you are, winning is still ano, parang your priority at the end of the day.
Number one thing pa rin ang pag-champion.
And ayun nga, like what I mentioned earlier, 100% committed na to rebuilding tong Portland Trail Blazers. Though naging questionable yung recent na roster move nila, na in hindsight they basically gave up Gary Trent for Eric Bledsoe. ganun yung nangyari. They got rid of Norman Powell, a solid wing scorer. Kumbaga siya yung primary scorer nila eh, nung wala si Lillard tsaka McCollum.
Borderline 20 points per game scorer yun eh.
They got rid of their
best defensive
best wing. best defender in Robert Covington. So ang natira na lang basically si Anfernee Simons. Wow. And si Yusuf Nurkic, na I think can still be traded before the trade deadline.
Actually, may rumors din for a trade for Nurkic. Ako, I'd like to see him in the Hornets or the Raptors.
Grabe yung Raptors. Idadagdag mo pa si Nurkic dun. Ang lakas na nun.
Kahit mabawas mo si Anunoby dun, ang lakas dun.
Yeah, they still have Scottie Barnes.
Scottie Barnes.
So, okay lang.
Pero ayun, going back to Portland, this is a major rebuild na. I mean, every asset na natitira, tapon yan. Even Josh Hart is an asset at this point. Kasi Josh Hart's not that young. His skill set is a widely needed skill set by any team in the NBA right now in the modern era. Tapos, ayun, you're gonna search for draft picks eh. Nakita natin yung ginawa ng OAC ng New Orleans ng Boston Celtics of all teams. Ayun. That's I think the blueprint for rebuilding teams now. Just collect draft picks, collect project players. And then if you're lucky enough, you get star players in the draft class, then maybe you find the disgruntled superstar, you add that to your team.
And so at least for the Portland Trail Blazers, may patutunguhan na yung team nila. Kasi similar sa parang ginawa ng Orlando Magic a season ago, na ay parang di tayo nakakalabas ng first round ah. Parang let's
restart. Tapusin na natin, no?
At least may direction na. So that's the silver lining in this situation ng Portland Trail Blazers. So mabibigyan na din ng pagkakataon yung mga young players nila to shine, like na Sir Little,
Anfernee Simons.
Halos siya na lang pala yung
natira. Halos siya na lang natira, tsaka si Nasir Little eh.
Wait, nasa Portland ba si Nasir Little? Wait lang ah.
Alam ko nasa Portland pa yan eh. Si Zach Collins yung wala na.
Ah oo, si Zach Collins nasa Spurs na pala ngayon, na ginagamit na. Ayan.
Baka naman nasa Portland pa si Zonya.
Ay wala na, wala na sa NBA.
Medyo lang, wala na.
Sa Euroleague na siya.
Pero baka gusto nila ibalik din.
Bigyan nila 10-day contract.
10-day contract muna.
And so,
I think kailangan natin discuss dito at least for a bit, where does Lillard go from here? Earlier I called Lakers, pero there's definitely other options.
Chile, dumadami na yung wishlist si Jello sa Lakers eh. Parang una si Tatum. Tapos,
yung Tatum talagang mangyayari talaga yun. Mangyayari yun. 2025. Tatum to the Lakers. Let's go.
Tapos kasama niya si Lillard. No? Pwede. Not bad. Pwede naman. Pero
AD, Tatum, Lillard. Let's go.
Pero, speaking of Damian Lillard, the 76ers are shipping yung favorite naming player na si Ben Simmons. James Harden is looking for a new team. Julius Randle is throwing tantrums sa New York Knicks bench. So mukhang in-unfollow niya sa Instagram yung Knicks. So baka may balak siya diyan. The Laker fans are desperately, well, the casual Laker fans are desperately wanting a trade for Russell Westbrook. Maraming possible destinations si Damian Lillard. Even ano, in the next few days sa trade deadline, which is by the time na malabas to, trade deadline na. So, tingnan lang natin ano yung mangyari.
And I wouldn't be surprised if the Lakers do make a move by tomorrow or by this coming day. Kasi, to be honest, the season's going not the good way. LeBron's often out of the lineup. So, why not save it for this season, then go all out again the next season? Parang ginawa nila nung ano, nung championship season nila. They save their players, then regroup, then make a big splash in the offseason.
So, ayan, sabi nga namin, the NBA, where amazing happens.
As for the Sixers, mukhang nagsinabi na kasi nila talaga na hindi nila ititrade si Ben Simmons, at least for this season. So, let's expect a move in the offseason. And Harden, would Harden be, would Kyrie and Damian Lillard work together ba? Parang, that's a question mark. If you're gonna look at other teams naman, is Boston a feasible option? Of course, they're gonna lose Jalen Green, Jalen Brown in that trade.
Or Tatum.
Or Tatum. If they consider Jalen Brown just as good as Tatum.
So, ayan. So, madaming possible scenarios. And, ano, shoutout lang sa 76ers. Ang kakapal na mukha ninyo. In-offer nyo ba naman si Ben Simmons straight up for James Harden? Walang papayag dun.
You're basically offering a player that's a borderline
MVP candidate
for an MVP candidate. Kahit sabi mo 32, 33 years old na si Harden, you're never gonna do that. No one's gonna give up Kobe Bryant, past prime Kobe Bryant, for Tracy McGrady. Walang gagawa nun.
Ayan, so ayun guys, share your thoughts. Tingin nyo, sinong nanalo sa trade na to? Anong ine-expect nyo kay CJ McCollum sa bago niyang team? And comment down below and mababasa namin yan, mapapag-usapan namin yan. So again, this is Palm Hoops Podcast. Make sure to like, comment, share this podcast to your friends, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And you can also follow us on Spotify, Anchor, and Google Podcast. Just check the description down below for the details. Our episodes are also available on our official Facebook page, so make sure to check it out. And don't forget to follow our socials at Palm Hoops on Instagram and Twitter, and yung personal handles namin ni Jello. Nandyan lang yan sa harap.
And guys, also, if you're a Filipino podcaster like us and gusto mong kumita sa podcast mo, you can go to podmetrics.co and use our code PALMHOOPSPODCAST when you register. Ayan, nagka-flash naman sa screen ninyo. And when you register, matutulungan nyo na yung podcast namin lumaki and mapapalaki nyo pa yung podcasting community dito sa Pilipinas. Kumita ka na, nakatulong ka pa sa community natin. Again, guys, if you wanna register your podcast para kumita, go to podmetrics.co and use our code PALMHOOPSPODCAST when you register. Lastly, ano pa ba? Siyempre, kung saan ako nagtatrabaho sa Shopee, use our link which is flashing on your screen right now when going to shopee.ispodlink.co/99 and makakatulong sa inyo yung makakuha ng vouchers and discounts. Sobrang sulit, natutulungan nyo na kami, nakakatulong pa kayo sa pamilya nyo, sa mga kaibigan nyo na makatipid. So yun guys, share that link, use that link whenever you are going to Shopee. Again, that is podlink.co/99.
Okay. So it has been another episode. Pasensya na kung medyo may mga dead airs kasi bago lang din sa amin tong balita to. Literally 1 minute before kami mag-shoot, doon namin nakita yung news na to. So medyo ano, pasensya if may mga na-miss kaming details kasi bago lang talaga siya.
Ano kasi, syempre pag gantong spicy, kailangan mo una.
Ayan. So again, I'm Jem, this is my partner Jello, we're Palm Hoops Podcast, and we'll see you in the next episode.
Lillard, the Lakers, confirmed 2023, let's go.